Tax Radio. Tax Radio. A Woman Radio 91.7. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays.
From 5:30 p.m.
With FIRS. Pays to pay your tax.
Let's start with, we're looking at the non-resident person's tax office. There was a publication recently in the papers regarding the establishment of NRPTO. Can you enlighten the public more on this?
Basically, it's an office that will help track all financial transactions. That law or the practice has always been in place. But instead of taxpayers not being able to have those inquiries or discussions centralized, they used to go to various tax offices in Lagos or in Abuja. So now we have formally let the public know that for transactions from non-resident transactions that have tax implications, there can be one central point where they can address those issues.
Who are non-resident taxpayers?
Well, just like the name implies, when you're non-resident, that means you have no fiscal presence in the country, but you have got transactions within another country. So those are considered as non-resident.
Okay, sir. Can you tell us what's the rationale behind the establishment of the NRPTO?
Well, like I said, the establishment, it has always been there. But what we have now done is that we've let the public realize that there's a centralized location where all issues that concern non-resident businesses or transactions in Nigeria can be addressed.
So how important is this segment of the taxpaying public? Why the specialized attention on them?
Well, it's very important because right now businesses are going digital, whether it be services, whether it will be the issue of providing services. And let me give a typical example. In the extractive industries now, you've got driverless trucks that go into the mines, take out the natural resource, and they can handle all the transactions without physically being present in that country. Now, if you look at the amount or the quantum of revenue generated and the amount of taxes that should be paid to those countries, that tells you that there's a need for such businesses to be tracked and made sure that the taxes are paid. Because we have a situation now, not only in Africa or Nigeria, the world all over, that certain businesses are not even taxed in any location. So basically it's following up those transactions from non-resident operators or businesses to make sure that there is a resident location where those taxes will be paid.
Okay, the issue of multi-taxation for non-resident persons has actually become a reoccurring decimal. How will the establishment of this office curb this?
No, I mean, between countries, we have what we call tax treaties, which also tries to ensure that you don't pay taxes in two different countries based on certain transactions. So where there's no tax treaty, it will be decided based on the business that has been carried out, where the tax liability will reside and where the taxes will be paid. And that should take care of the issue of what you're trying to refer to as multiple taxation in more than one country.
So must the non-resident taxpayer come to Lagos to file or pay?
No, they don't have to come to Lagos to file or pay. All these things can be done online. If, for example, they have, you can say, an agent who happens to be local, they can also come in physically, but they don't. Right now, the way business is operated, the way tax payments are being made, you don't physically have to be in any one location. All these things can be online, the same way the services are done online. Let me give you a typical example. You have a software, maybe you bought from a company in Canada or in Germany or wherever, and you need an update of that software. And I'm sure a lot of us do that. At times you have your smartphone and you want to update the operating software. All you do is click a button and it updates it. Now, it doesn't update it from your shop next door in Nigeria. It's updated from a central location, maybe in America or in Germany. Or you have an issue with the software that you're using for your production and you want to move to the next level. You make a payment, no physical individual or no one comes to your place of business. you get onto the internet and it's downloaded to you. So a lot of transactions are now being done online, the same way with payments. You don't have to be physically present in one location to make a payment in another location.
Tax Radio.
Tax Radio.
A Woman Radio 91.7. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays.
From 5:30 p.m.
With FIRS. It pays to pay your tax.
How long will it take you to get out these goods?
I'm on it, sir. They said I should bring our team.
Our team? What thing?
Custom has changed. And the FIRS said...
What has FIRS got to do with clearing my goods? I'll talk to Garba myself. You're fired.
Sir?
Garba, which one be our team again?
The taxpayer identification number is the new and only approved means of transaction with the Nigeria Customs Service. You can process your free TIN in minutes at any FIRS office.
Soji!
You fired me now, sir.
Get our TIN.
This message is from Federal Inland Revenue Service and the Nigeria Customs Service.
Sir, our tax liability is 167,250 naira only. But if we pay through the boys, we can remit 100,000 naira and settle them for as little as 20,000 naira. That way, we save money. Can I go ahead, sir?
Oh, no, you can't. Why can't we pay the exact tax due to us? Why should we pay through touts? FIRS has told us that we can pay directly to their collecting banks. That way, we will not be enriching the pockets of unworthy touts. In fact, when we pay to the banks, we save time and avoid soiling our company's name.
The FIRS is taking steps to ensure that tax payment is convenient for you. Pay direct to the banks and receive your electronic acknowledgement immediately. FIRS. It pays to pay your taxes.
Tax Radio.
Tax Radio.
A Woman Radio 91.7. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays.
From 5:30 p.m.
With FIRS. It pays to pay your tax.
Okay, sir. How will the establishment of NRPTO promote voluntary tax compliance and help to reduce tax disputes?
Well, in two ways. Number one, some people might say because they do not know who to contact that they're willing to pay these taxes, but because they didn't have any contact person or a contact office, they would not pay. Where there are questions to be asked, people can go to this office or contact these individuals and ask questions. Apart from the laws guiding taxation, there are other two very key issues. One is the knowledge or the understanding that you have to pay certain taxes. Number two is the convenience of the payment of those taxes, the process in which you have to follow to even comply with the tax regulations in that country.
Finally, will non-resident taxpayers now file their returns with FIRS or SBIRS?
Well, they're different. Just like the name connotes, SB are the state revenue agencies. For corporate organizations, they're actually under the purview of the Federal Inland Revenue Service. So they'll file their annual returns with the Federal Inland Revenue Services. However, if they're transactions that involve individuals, then they'll file with the State Boards of Internal Revenue.
Tax Radio.
Tax Radio.
A Woman Radio 91.7. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays.
From 5:30 p.m.
With FIRS. It pays to pay your tax.
Moshe, na here the man go pass.
Na here na, See and they come. See and they come soon.
Mr. Man, now you the cheat madam ba? What happened?
You know, one are not paying me my correct money when I finish soon I work. Let me be this.
But madam, I know she too now. The money now for withholding tax.
Withholding waiting.
Withholding tax now advance of your income tax money. When you do work like contract or you collect rent, person will go pay you, go remove small shishi from your money. You know now, that person must wire that money, go FIRS within 30 days, and FIRS go give the person withholding tax credit with your name to take sure say you don't pay your tax in advance. This method do now to help you make the money where you go pay, make you no big for eye when year end.
Okay, this withholding tax explanation don't clear for my eye. Okay, I beg no verse. Give me this sec, make her the go.
Baba ne, we dey go, no vex you. FIRS, he go pay you, make you pay your tax.
tomorrow, the future, the say belongs to us.
But what kind of life would we live if we inherit a country that does not work?
Well, the tap doesn't run.
A country with no good schools, healthcare facilities.
Where lives are not safe.
And no hope of finding jobs after a painful education. For so long, you, our parents, have been talking about our future.
Now is the time to start doing something about it.
By paying your tax.
Paying your tax to help secure your today and our tomorrow too.
Paying gives you the power to demand that those who govern deliver on what they promise. That's why I'm standing up for my future.
Daddy,
Mommy, be my champion. Stand up, pay your tax.
FIRS, it pays to pay your tax.
WFM 91.7.